Hello friends, I welcome you all to .NET 6 Amazon Web Services course. Today in this video, we are going to discuss about AWS Global Infrastructure. What are the components? What is actually AWS Global Infrastructure? What are its components? Where all it's distributed and how you can use, why it is important to understand it properly. Now the map is on your screen of entire globe representing different continents. And these orange color circle, if it is, I hope it is clear to you on your screen. These orange color circles is actually representing different regions across the globe where AWS has hosted its facility to offer its services, its data centers, its infrastructure, physical infrastructure. So these are the current established one, the orange circle. And the number inside these circles is actually represent the number of availability zones. So North Virginia has the maximum number of availability zone inside it. What are the regions? What are the availability zone? We'll come back to this discussion. Here on the right side of the screen, if you see, there are in different geographies, the distribution of different regions being listed out here. We see in US East geography, there are North Virginia region with 6 availability zone, Ohio with 3, US West, North California region with 3 availability zone, Oregon with 3 availability zone, Asia Pacific region, Mumbai, we have 2, Seoul 2, Singapore 3, Sydney 3, Tokyo 4, and Osaka local 1. In Canada, Central 2, China, Beijing, Ningxia is 2 and 3 respectively. In Europe, there are 4 current regions are there. Frankfurt, Ireland, London, Paris, having 3 availability zone each. In South America also, there is a Sao Paulo region where 3 availability zones are there. And in AWS GovCloud, there are 3 availability zones. Upcoming regions in the AWS global infrastructure is Bahrain, Hong Kong, Sweden, AWS GovCloud. So the first Middle East region is about to establish on the map. Now, you may argue that in North Virginia, there are 6 availability zones, in Ohio, 3 and other, like, why this disparity is there in availability zone and why in Osaka local it's 1. See, the local region can have 1 availability zone due to there are certain compliance region as laid out by that particular country. Otherwise, to create one region or to say that this particular AWS infrastructure is actually a region, or it's such a big infrastructure that you can call it a region, you have to have a existence of at least 2 availability zone. If there are less than 2 availability zone, if you say that one data center or one facility or a couple of facility cannot create one availability zone or one region. Okay. What is availability zone? We will come back to this discussion. But in short, let me again remind you, a region will only be called a region, an AWS region, when there is a presence of at least 2 availability zone. Less than 2? No, it's not a region. Understanding AWS global infrastructure in more detail. Amazon cloud computing resources are hosted in multiple locations worldwide. So it's nothing but a geographical distinct regions. Distinct geographies where AWS infrastructure is lying and servicing you, providing their services. They are geographically isolated. They are self-sufficient to run. And natural calamity, God forbid, if there's any natural calamity stuck to any particular country or any particular region, the other regions will remain unaffected by that natural calamity. So it's an important part to understand this thing when you are thinking about business continuity plans. All these locations are composed of AWS regions and availability zone. So in short, these physically distinct locations in different geographies been called AWS region, and inside AWS region there are availability zones. And in total there are 55 availability zones currently inside 18 geographic regions distributed over different geographies, one local region. And there is announced plan for 12 more availability zone and 4 more regions in Bahrain, Hong Kong, Sweden, and second AWS GovCloud in the US. So I have already explained this thing up in my previous slide. Talking about AWS region, I have already given you a bit of understanding, conceptual knowledge about this. Going to through this dedicated slide on AWS region. AWS region is a separate geographic area. Each AWS region has multiple isolated locations known as availability zones. AWS region is created once AWS has at least two availability zones. So this is the information that I was stressing upon. Presence of two availability zones at least creates an AWS region. AWS regions are created to reduce the latency for business continuity and for disaster recovery measures. AWS doesn't replicate resources across region due to the data residency laws, due to various compliance measures that a company or an organization or a country takes. So inside the region, yes, there are some managed services which replicate your data over different facilities just to increase the durability and meet the fault tolerance SLA. But outside the region, cross-region replication can be achievable, but via manual intervention when you yourself configure that particular feature. Talking about the other component of AWS infrastructure is AWS availability zone. An availability zone is a combination of one or more data centers inside a region. So regions are combination of two or more than two availability zone. Availability zone is a combination of one or more data center inside a region. Each region is consist of at least two AZs. Again, a redundant information which we are reading again and again. AZs are physically separated and located inside a metropolitan city. So these are not some laying something remotely or in some barren land. They are very much in the city center. But location of them remain most of the time anonymous. Nobody knows where are the data center exactly, where AZs are actually located in AWS infrastructure, which particular building or which particular, you say, locality it's they are lying. No, because due to, yes, self-explanatory security reasons and compliance measures are located in lower risk floodplain. So there's like some people who are from Indian, some continent can argue why they created in Mumbai. It's there too much water logging problem sometimes during the monsoon, but it's not the case. They've been selected by doing proper research on different and very critical parameters, and that's why they chose any particular region, any particular geography for hosting their infrastructure. These availability zones fed electricity via different grids. So in case, even worst case scenario, even if one complete grid goes down, even then the electricity is going to be supplied. Although they also have their various power solution like gensets and UPS and other things, solar panels. And that's one thing that brings to this discussion, that they have made is AWS has achieved already a carbon neutral footprint for themselves. I guess it was in 2015 that they achieved, maybe 2014 and 2015, they actually achieved this thing. AZs are connected with each other via high speed, low latency links. So the data replication between or information progress between different nodes, different AZs inside a region is pretty much fast and with double digit millisecond latency I'm talking about here, because the link which is set between them is a very high bandwidth. I'm talking about on a scale of terabits per second speed. So you can understand that inside region, if you deploy your infrastructure in a redundant manner distributed over different AZs, it's very much fault tolerant and remain very much available. The last topic of discussion, endpoints and edge location, also very crucial component of global infrastructure. Endpoints are URLs which serve as an entry point for specific Amazon web services, whereas AWS edge locations are where end users access services located at AWS. They are specifically used by AWS CDN service, which is called CloudFront. So I hope most of you, those who are in the software architects or developers, they know about the CDN, major CDN service of the world, Akamai. In the same way, they have brought the solution CloudFront, which works as a content delivery network service, CDN service for AWS. And where they are hosted, it's that hosted place, it's called AWS edge locations. Sometimes this question may appear that like which number you predict will be more between edge locations, availability zone and regions. So regions are the least in numbers. Of course, there are the different geographies. We have limited number of geographies. Inside regions, there are edge locations. Inside regions, there are availability zones. So edge locations and availability zone are two different concepts. But if you go by the number, you will find that the edge locations are more. Very recently, they have also introduced, every now and then they keep on introducing newer and newer edge locations. In Indian subcontinent, if I talk about, very recently, they also introduced Bengaluru edge locations. It was a very latest update on this. So that's it, guys. I guess that's very much covered the AWS global infrastructure concept. And why the last thing that I should discuss here is why we are giving too much stress over global infrastructure. In bits and pieces, I have already shared the information with you, but let me explain you in brief what actually I meant by that. Understanding of AWS global infrastructure actually helped you in designing a highly available app, an app with high availability. You distribute your infrastructure on various availability zone available. You create redundant applications hosted on different availability zones. So in case if there is some unknown issue get stuck to one availability zone or some kind of fault arise due to some XYZ reason like network or electricity, still you have one other availability zone serving your customer. So your application, your web services remain highly available. Understanding regions improve business continuity plan. Understanding availability zone, distributing your infrastructure across regions, across availability zone is actually improve your business continuity and meet your business data disaster recovery compliance parameters. So that's the one I was talking about. It helps you in meeting compliance, and it also helps you in geographic expansion. So suppose you want to expand your business to certain location where you previously didn't have any kind of footprint. Like suppose you are in, let's say you are a Middle East, you are a company based out in Middle East, like Dubai somewhere, and you want to communicate with the customers or clients sitting in Australian region, you need to know whether that particular region has those facilities, has those services and the requisite infrastructure to support your business. So if you have that understanding with you about different regions, because there are many services you will found which are not available in particular region and available in other region. Here I want to give you one more thing, a piece of information here. Most of the AWS services which ever been introduced, they've been introduced always first in US East North Virginia region, which also incidentally carry the maximum number of availability zone. So that is also one among the reason that since it is carry the maximum number of availability zone, so the scope of trial and error and test is much more in AWS North Virginia region than in comparison to other geographies or regions or availability zone, because the number of availability zone is high. So most of the time, in fact almost all the time, whenever a new service is released, it's always released in North Virginia region. But the new services does take time to reach to other part of the continents, other part of the geographies, other part of the globe. But sometimes it does take time. So Elastic File System, which we are going to discuss during our storage service section, it's actually not available near Indian subcontinent. Okay, so that's one example. And there are other services also which are recently been introduced on disruptive ideas like AI, ML or VR. Some services are not available in some certain geographies. So that's it guys, that's very much cover our presentation on AWS global infrastructure. If you have any question and query for me or any feedback for our course, want to update some information or get something corrected, please reach out us on our .NETrix page, and we are very much here to listen you and take a necessary action on your generous feedbacks. Thank you very much.